for tuning in. This is Optibonomus coming to you with another video review. And today we're going to be taking a look at the new X-Transbots Apollyon. One of the most anticipated third-party figures in the collector community, Apollyon represents something that fans have really said that we've needed for a very long time. That being an updated masterpiece Megatron. Now, whether we ever get an official one really does remain to be seen. But for all intents and purposes, we have pretty much gotten every other Decepticon from Season 1 of Transformers. We've got Starscream, Thundercracker, Skywarp, Soundwave, all the mini-bots like Laserbeak, Ravage, Rumble. I mean, that's pretty much all the Decepticons. One could say that, yeah, we're missing the Decepticons that were on Cybertron, but we even kind of got some of those. And we're obviously not getting a Shockwave anytime soon, or Reflector, or even the Constructicons. Who knows what we're going to be getting? But we needed a new Megatron. And since Takara was kind of leaving us all wondering if we're ever going to, X-Transbots decided to fill that void. Now, for the packaging, you can see you got this kind of cool-looking reflective foil kind of thing right there. You can see moving it around. You get this cool color shift. But really, that's all about it. It is a slipcover. You got X-Transbots right there in that same kind of foil, and then this whole section here just slides out like so. Get this out of the way, and you're left with kind of a masterpiece-ish looking actual package. You got X-Transbots Master X Series 84 MX1 liter Apollyon. You got an image here of the toy. Really heavy duty cardboard, very high quality on here. You can see from Liberty's Ashes, Order Arises, and whatever. It's all fancy sounding. You come around here to the back, and this is actually kind of interesting. You can see, obviously, Apollyon, a couple other figures, like you got Ollie, and then some of their other figures. And then you can also see, down here, you got some blurred images kind of hinting towards Cyclonus and Scourge, and you got Scourge kind of right there. What they're going to call him, I'm not exactly sure, but X-Transbots has, unfortunately, had a history of bad quality control, and Apollyon here, being the first company to really kind of take on that masterpiece Megatron challenge, I guess, has been definitely put under the microscope, especially with some of their previous figures really falling short of a lot of people's expectations. And this is one that a lot of people have been looking forward to, so naturally it's going to be met with some criticisms and high expectations. But really nice package though. You can open this up. It's got this little Velcro thing, and then when you open it up, you've got two different sides here. One side here that holds the figure. The other side here holds the majority of his accessories. And then you got the X-Transbot little sticker kind of holding it all together. But for the package, you kind of wiggle that together to get it to stick. For the package, though, that's about it. So without further ado, let's get him out here and see how cool he actually is. All right, guys, so here we have Apollyon opened up and out of its packaging. Now, when you do get him, he will come in robot mode. But as I start off with all my videos, we're going to take a look at his alternate form first. But here are all of his accessories. You can't even see them all. But first off, he does come with a nice collector card. It is a kind of credit card thick plastic piece with a bit of a read up here. And then obviously some technical specifications. Here's his comic book or instruction manual. It is very similar to how Masterpiece ones are. You got a similar read up right there. You got all of his accessories kind of laid out. Then you go through, that's all the instructions. I will say that the instructions aren't bad. They're not really anything spectacular, but I do honestly wish that they were a little bit better. There are some tricky parts on here, but overall, it's pretty good. Come around here, it does have instructions on how to put the batteries in. I haven't gotten batteries for it. Those are the types of batteries that you do need. So if you want to pause it and kind of mark that down, so I won't be able to show off the light up feature. But come around here to the back, and then you got the actual comic section right here, and it kind of hints at some future figures like Scourge and the Sweeps. So you do have those, and then obviously you do have the main product right here. That's one of the issues I have with it, but you do have that. You do have the scope here, which also dubs as his fusion cannon in his actual robot mode. Now, one thing that I'd like to do is bring in the original MP05, and you can see there is a big size difference here. This is a much smaller handgun, but you can see that the MP05 just kind of dwarfs this. And obviously, this is a much older design, and this is obviously much more updated to actually fit with the new scale for Masterpiece figures. So, in reducing the size for the robot mode, is naturally going to reduce the size of the gun, and I'm knocking stuff down. But one thing that this set comes with, that the original one didn't, is actually this scope. Now, you could buy a third-party scope that you could use for it, but it was an extra add-on accessory, so not really official or anything, but you just slide that in just like so. You can take this, and then you got a little clip section right here, and just slide this down. Let me see if I can get that lined up properly. And maybe, no, are you going to slide in there? There it is. Maybe I'm putting in upside down. Let me try this way, sorry. I think it might go easier that way. There we go. And you can knock things off like that too. So peg that in there. It comes in different segments. There's actually three of them, but there you have more of a cartoon look for it, which really does look cool. I really enjoy this. It definitely gives a much better gun representation of Megatron from the actual cartoon. So you do get that as an accessory. It can be used as a stand, which I'll show off here later on in actual robot mode. Now, I will comment on this. All of these do have to have this little orange cap. You got the orange cap here on the silencer. You also got the orange cap here on the actual gun itself. Now, because of U.S. laws, these are required to be permanently affixed to the toy itself. How permanent? Not really all that permanent. As you can see, this just pops off. Now, it was glued on. I did use, honestly, my teeth. I just grabbed hold of it and twisted and it popped right off, but you can see that there was some glue on there. Same thing with this, so you can remove these. I've seen people that have talked about how they are very secure and much harder to get off than my actual figure, so you can take that off. It is something that is not possible to do, and I'll do the remainder of this video without these little orange pieces. So you do have those for the accessories. Robot mode, he does come with a few other ones. First up, he does come with this little sword that is very reminiscent of how, I guess, his sword looked when he battled Optimus Prime in the original 80s movie. It's similar. It's not exact, but it definitely gives a nice homage to that. And I do like it. You got that translucent purple plastic, so you can see it gives a very Energon-ish sort of look. And then very similar how he comes with that weapon from the movie, he also comes with this weapon from the original first episode of Transformers, and that is his Energon mace. You got a nice metal chain right here. You got that translucent ball section with the spikes and everything. Really very cool. This piece right here just clips on to his actual hand, but again, we'll show that off here when we take a look through the robot mode. He also does come with one more movie kind of accessory, and that is his gun that he actually shot Optimus Prime with, kind of delivering the final blow to him as it is. Really nice. Very similar, and again, much like the sword, not exact, but definitely gives you that kind of look, I suppose. And I really do dig a real nice paint on there as well. He also does come with a couple extra episode specific pieces. This bit right here can just be swapped out with a chest piece, and it is kind of like a little asteroid on there. That's what resulted in him getting Cosmic Rust. So I do like that they included that. It's a nice little touch. It's not something I'm really going to display him with, but it is pretty cool. And then here on the back, you can see some actually nice molded detail. I'm really very impressed with that. That's actually really very cool. He also does come with this helmet that he used in an episode to control the clone of Optimus Prime. If you guys remember, the Constructicons built him, and Megatron tried to use it to try to trick the Autobots, and this was the helmet that actually controlled that clone. So it is, again, another piece that is very episode-specific. But it's pretty cool, and I do appreciate this. He also does come with, and I really love this, it's very small and it's very neat, but he also does come with the key to Vector Sigma, a really nice gold paint on there and some really nice detail. Now, I do have the Vector Sigma that came with the Botcon Alpha Trion. It's a lot larger than this, but this is definitely a cool piece to also have. And honestly, I think that this is better. It's definitely more scaled for these figures as opposed to that Botcon piece, but this is really very nice. nice. I wish we did have like an actual vector sigma that we could use this with, but I did see somewhere, and I do apologize, I'm not sure who posted the picture or who did it, so I can't give credit to them, but they showed that the reissue Optimus Prime, the MP10, that did come with a little vector sigma, apparently this scales well with that, so if you do have that, this is a nice piece to add to it. So there's that. The other thing that he does come with, and I do have to give X-Transbots props for doing this. There are several problems with the figure. I'll touch on that here later on, but one of the biggest was the actual shoulders. That being, he had a hard time actually extending his arms out, specifically his right arm that had the fusion cannon on it. So when you would extend it out, they would just fall right back down. So you do get replacement shoulders, which are apparently much tighter. Now, a lot of people that have already gotten actual production versions, and mind you, this is a production version. This is not a test sample or anything of that nature. This came directly from Big Bad Toy Store. So a lot of the people that are getting production versions are saying that the shoulders are, again, way too loose. But when you put these on, they're now way too stiff, almost to the point that they feel like they might break something because of how stiff the actual joint is now. You can't actually get any rotation. So you do get the replacements. I'm probably just going to use some floor polish on the actual ball section, try to tighten that up just myself. But I do like that they include this. They also include a little screwdriver for you to actually swap that out. So that's really very cool. But those are all of his accessories, except for, obviously, the giant fusion cannon there. But gun-wise, it really does look pretty cool. Now, there are, like I said, some problems with it, mostly in the way that I guess it's designed. I'm really not a big fan of the transformation, and I'm going to tell you guys right now, you've already watched several minutes of this, I am not going to go into the transformation instructions on this. It's just, it's not fun, and I do not like it. I have transformed this currently about 22 times, I think I counted. And every single time, I cannot get all of these panels lined up. I don't like the way that this is engineered. This is really very panel-y. And every time that I push something together, like for example these, if I push this to get this, you know, oh, that actually didn't pop out. So, oh no, up here popped out. So you push that together and, well, that popped out. So as you squeeze everything, that now has come undone. And then this pops out. It just, nothing tabs together very well. This whole section right here also then slides down to kind of lock into place. And again, very kind of, I will say fiddly. I don't necessarily like using that word, but it is very fiddly. But I will admit that it does look pretty cool. I just can't keep everything together. And it's, like I said, something that I've tried transforming several times, and it is unfortunate. Now, you also see this piece right here. This flops out very easily, coming around here to this side. This section is part of his chest. It just flops. Oh, well, now it's not. But oh, there it is. See, you can see. You hold it there, and it just flops out. This is also fairly loose. I have tightened this, but it is a little bit floppy still. It's not terrible, but I did put some pledge on there, and here's... this section here is coming apart, and it's so all that it's supposed to come off. So it is very just, it's unfortunate because the gun mode is, I mean, very cool looking, and I really do like it. You guys know that when I do my videos, a lot of times when I judge things, I judge it on the way that the alt mode looks, the way that the robot mode looks, and also the transformation. I really do like the way that the gun mold looks. There's some die cast in here, like this is all die cast. It does feel very hefty. There are parts on here that do feel a little bit fragile, but all in all, because it's X-Transbot, there was a lot of concern about how the quality is. I will say that the quality is really good on this, far better than anything that I've gotten from them previously. But there are just some parts about it that I just feel are not there. You can see that it fits in a hand pretty good. It is still oversized. I do like the spring here is actually really very strong. I like the way that that feels. You got this moving section right here for a, you know, a safety and a fire mechanism right there. So that doesn't move or anything. The hammer, I should say. You can't see through there or anything, but that's the light up section here. And then you just turn this to get it to actually light up. But like I said, gun wise, I think it looks really cool. Just getting it here is really not very fun. And I apologize. I know a lot of you guys watch my videos for those transformation instructions. It's just really not a very fun process. So again, I do wholeheartedly apologize to you guys. It would just make the video unnecessarily long, and you would just hear my frustration with it. Especially, like I said, here in this. I mean, this is all just one big multi-panel surface kind of thing. You can see that there are some scratches kind of right up in here. That's possible that that has happened from transforming it. The paint on here is really nice, but it does seem very prone to scratches. And when you move things around, I mean, you can kind of lose sight of those scratches, but they're always going to be there. Now, on the, I don't know how well that's going to come across on the actual chest. And again, see, because I use so much light, it's going to kind of hide, but there was a scratch right across there. It's very minor, but you can see it in some angles. And then you're also seeing one of the problems that a lot of people kind of had with this initially is that there is some dimpling in here, and you can really see it, that it looks like there's four little dimples. And now people have joked and they said that, oh, I will just pretend that that's Optimus Prime punching them. And okay, you can only see it really in some angles, but I mean, like, for example, there you obviously don't see it, and then oh, there it is. So it just depends on how the light hits it, but all in all, I mean, I do like it. It is it's obvious homage to G1 Megatron. That's what this is meant to be. So in that respect, X-Transbots really did a great job of nailing how this looks. Now, as I said, I am not going to show the transformation on this. So because of that, we're going to go from a Polyon looking like this to looking like this. Now, taking a look at all of his accessories on him right up front, obviously he's got his sword. He also does come with his handgun. They got the little tabs on here, so all you do is come around here, the fingers just come out, and you got the little slot on the inside here that you just take this, put that in there, and boom. Now you can have him holding his Energon sword. You can also do the same thing with this gun. It's your personal preference, whichever you want to actually have him holding. So there's that. Obviously, the very easy accessory is his helmet. You just slot that right on there like so, and you can control Optimus Prime. Now this little piece right here, this just attaches right on this section right here. You just pull that off and put that right on there, and that's basically how it looks. I'm not going to do it, but you get the general idea. You can have him holding the key to Vector Sigma. That's available for you. Obviously, I don't need to have you see that or anything. The actual ball and chain, you just take the hand. You'll take this section here. You got to transform a little bit, and then you just slide this in, and then this just clips on there. One thing that I will say is that I kind of feel like the chain's a little bit too long. When you have it attached to him, it's like, oh, I'm just going to take that off. When you have it attached to him, I mean, that's kind of a big chain. I don't know, maybe taking a few links off, like shortening it up to about, instead of there, maybe like here or something. But it's just that, to me, it's just a little bit too long. It's not bad. I just would be a little bit happier if it was a little bit shortened. Then setting him to the back, this is his probably, I guess, biggest accessory. And this all detaches and can become a battle stand. First, what you want to do is separate this. Now, I do have a couple problems with mine, and I'm going to show you that. This section right here, this pulls out. I'm using a little wedge because I can't get this out otherwise. Oh, well, I guess I can. Now, this has a little tiny cross peg that is supposed to attach to the underside here, except it doesn't. I cannot get mine to tab in there. It's the actual slot is like way... No, that didn't do nothing. The slot here is just too small, but it's supposed to go underneath there just like so. And then we're going to take these, we're going to separate all these pieces. Make sure you pull. I did see PL's video. He unfortunately twisted his, and unfortunately that did break it, but you just want to pull it away. Then you take this section right here. Again, you have to fold this little nub out. It's not easy to get to, but getting it to rotate around is kind of a problematic thing for, well, at least for me. And then these little pieces right here, these are going to come out as well. So getting that, where do I gotta get a little lever or something, but that doesn't want to swivel out. So let's see if I can get it in this area. I know people hate when I use it, but I need to use this little razor bit right here to get in. There we go. And you pull that out. It just doesn't want to come out very easily. There we go. So you do have that section right there. Then you take this and you come around, and then you just peg this in just like that. You just wedge that in there, and that's that section right there. Then come around here. Actually, you got to take this part, and this slots out too. At least I think this section does. Otherwise, I'm missing a part. Actually, yeah, I think that's... another piece. Well, no, it's actually supposed to stay attached there, but for some reason they show that it detaches. So it doesn't, but it tricks you a little bit. So then you just peg that right on there. Then you come around here, you take this, and you peg this in just like so. And then these are the handles for it. And then actually you take this section here and you split this. Let's see here. Let's get that separate. And then just angle that down, swivel these out like so. Then take this, keep that on there. And there's his little battle platform. Again, this is supposed to be attached on the bottom side, but for some reason, mine doesn't. So I'm kind of SOL, basically. Now there's another assembly way to do it. You take this off, and that whole thing's just gonna detach. Take this off. God, that really gets on there stiff. And then you take this section, you kind of rotate this around, and then you bring this into this section right there, pushing that into place. But again, this doesn't like, let me see if I get up. Yeah, I can't, for some reason, maybe it's just this peg right here is too big. It doesn't seem to fit in there whatsoever. So you can't really, at least on mine, I can't do the alternate assembly on here, which is really kind of unfortunate because I actually prefer that look. And just forcing that in there, and it doesn't do anything. But basically what you do is you have this like that, then you can actually take this cannon, you can straighten this out across that top section, and then you can bring this on right there, and you got this little bit right here that's gonna sit like that. This bit right here comes around here, this slots down. There's actually a little section here that pops out. I have no idea how to get this section out, but this section is supposed to come out. Oh, there we go. All right, there we are. I have like a bit of a fingernail. So you take this, and then you slide this under here, maybe. Nah, a lot of little fiddly parts with this. So get that like that. And again, I did that the wrong way, so we're gonna go like that, sorry. Keep that all the way in just like so. And then this piece right here then comes around and you attach it on the underside. But again, I don't know how you're supposed to do that because that's a cross little hole and that's a round peg. So how you do that, I have no idea. But that's what you're supposed to have, and it's supposed to be like that. And I actually like the way that that looks a whole lot better. I think that's cool. I just, like I said, I can't get this in. It's unfortunate because it does not fit. It's, like I said, it's like this peg is just too big. But that's the cool looking combination that also does incorporate Megatron's fusion cannon. Now, if you don't want to take Megatron's fusion cannon off, you do have that other alternate battle stand mode. But it is all personal preference. Now, coming to the figure himself. And in terms of robot mode, this is where this figure actually absolutely shines. Now, as I did say, there are a few problems with it. As I pointed out, you do have the little bit of a chest scratch on there. That's not that big of a deal. I also really do not like these hands. I don't know how much I can actually bring this in to show you the thumb specifically, but it is a very small joint. It's very ridiculously tiny. Let me see if I can actually bring that in some. It's not going to be easy to show it because of how close I need to get, but you can kind of sort of, well, no, not really. I mean, it's just so ridiculously thin there that I do not like how it actually is. The hands are not really my favorite part on this figure at all. I mean, you can even see like right through there just how thin. Oh, well, let me see if I can get it in the right light. You can kind of see it. Just what attaches to the main part of the hands is just way too thin, I think. I like how they actually put a molded section on the back here to kind of replicate the actual Decepticon logo. I think that's kind of cool. Now, like I said, I didn't go over the transformation, and some of the parts on here for the actual transformation really do feel very flimsy. You come around here to the inside of the leg. These pieces right here, they all just kind of sit up here. This piece specifically kind of bothers me how it just hangs there. It can get caught on things. And you can see it just kind of flops around. But if you keep it all compressed in, it's not that bad. But it does give me a reason to be concerned. This whole section right here, this is the part that is the most annoying in the transformation of them. And then you got to get all this stuff to kind of line up, and this is where like the whole section here, and I'm just kind of transforming his legs for you. All of these bits right here have to kind of fit together, and I feel like this piece, like right here, you kind of have to force this down. You have to like pull away to get it to fit around here, and then come up. The tab sections don't really tab in very good, but it's a part that I don't particularly care for. And then let me see here. This is supposed to attach to something. I want to say, but I don't ever know. But it's not very easy to get everything to tab together, and that's one of the most unfortunate aspects of the transformation. Honestly, the transformation I do not feel is more complicated than MP05. I think that MP05 has a harder transformation, but this guy is just very fiddly, and I just kind of feel like when I'm moving stuff, it kind of is bumping in other parts, and I don't particularly like that. Especially you come around here to the back. This whole section is die-cast. There is some die-cast in here. You got some die-cast in the legs and things like that. So there's a good amount of heft to this guy. But when you come here to the back, the other part is this whole section comes up and attaches to the shoulders very much like MP05 did. And then you have to wedge this forward, and you have to get this section here, and this is not going to be too terribly easy to do, but you have to like bend this away from the body and then pull this section out. I'm going to try doing it here and see if I can. So you have to really pull on this to get it to loosen up, and then when you do, this whole section comes around, and this piece, this I feel is pretty, that's one of the problems. So you have to bring this up, and then this section actually does rotate down, but I feel in pushing it down, it's going to snap this, and this is just a piece of plastic, so it feels fairly sturdy, but when you're pushing, that's when things break, and that's what worries me about it. I really don't like this piece at all, and you can see that it kind of bends it down, so putting this back up, that's supposed to stay there. Now, one other problem that some people have talked about is because the way that the paint is, it can scratch things, as you did see on the actual gun mode. They actually have this piece right here that says the Apollyon, a scratch-free film. It's a little piece of plastic that goes there, which I do kind of appreciate, and then you just put that up. The other thing that I've noticed that when you separate these legs, this section right here is spring-loaded, and it flexes in just like so, and that has a piece of film on there as well. So you bring this around, and that's what you attach. Now, one thing I'll talk about is you do have to make sure that you have these little pieces on the inside here. These little bits, those little tabs that are sticking out, are going to lock into the leg. So when you bring this in, this section right here pushes this little panel in, and you want to wedge everything together, and that holds the leg together. And that gives a lot of stability to these waist pieces. If you don't have that properly assembled, now these will not stay attached. And if you rotate the legs, this will just come flying out. Already you can see that in doing so, it's not a full, not perfect tab, but it works fairly nicely. So bringing this back out. Now, this is part of the other problem that I have, and a lot of other people have, and it's fixed by them giving us these extra shoulder sockets. But I do appreciate that, but I really do wish that they would have actually recognized this as a problem before they sent the figures out. I don't necessarily think it would have delayed things any longer, because they have these, so I don't see that why they couldn't have waited an extra week. We had already waited a ridiculous amount of time for this figure. Why not push it back a couple days to make sure that they got the right sizes? These are just way too tight. Now, most people have had that problem. Not everybody, but some people have. And it's kind of unfortunate, but and pulling this out, part of the reason why I think it is a problem in coming in here to take a look at that, well, not going back, you can kind of see what's happening on in here. Hopefully you can see that. It's kind of like a slice in there. Like, imagine a, I guess, orange slice, like a quarter of an orange slice. That's what the actual socket is. So when you have it in there, It rotates perfectly fine. Oh, that one came off too. It rotates perfectly fine. And putting his fusion cannon back on him, get that tabbed in. Just like so. Rotating is perfectly fine because you're not really changing too much. If you got the whole section right here, you put that, it's rotating. It's going to be meeting resistance the entire way. The problem that this figure has is because it's like this, and doing it like when you rotate like that, there isn't an extra piece up here. It's not a full circle. So when you slide it out, they just collapse down. This one's not bad because there's no real weight on it, but you can feel that that one's actually kind of loose. That's really loose. Now, the other thing that I'm going to show you, and I saw a video, I'm not sure remember who did it. I know that he's a customizer, which is why when I first saw it, I really didn't believe kind of anything in his video because it's very possible that he fixed it beforehand, but he took this and he held it by the shoulder and he shook it. Now, I don't have to shake it. I'm just going to hold it here. So watch. That's how loose mine is. It holds no weight at all. I cannot even do it. Now, let's look at the other arm. Hold that up. Nothing. It will not support that. So I don't know what he was doing when he was shaking it to make it work. It doesn't do it. Now, you can use these replacement shoulders. As I said, a lot of people talk about how tight they are. Or instead of using these, there's a lot of other options such as the Pledge Future Shine, which if you buy a new bottle of it, this is what it is, so you know what you want to be getting. You put this on there, it no longer says Future Shine on it or anything. I just got this at Walmart, but it says multi-surface finish, and it is by Pledge. You put this on there, and it creates a little bit of thickness around that ball section. Literally, all you do, you just take this off. You put this on a Q-tip, just dip the Q-tip in there, rub it on there, let it cure for a while. And by that, I mean dry and kind of thicken up. And then you'll be able to put that on there, and it'll hold very nicely. I already did it, but because it is just floor polish, you can wipe it off. So I tested it. It worked. Then I wiped it off so that I can actually show you guys the floppiness of the video. But this is a nice non-permanent solution. A lot of people will use clear nail polish. That's another alternative, but that's also basically permanent. This is not permanent. So that's something that I would recommend using. Now, despite all the problems that the figure does have, and there are some, as you could plainly see, this is still the best representation of G1 Megatron that we've ever gotten, and it does look phenomenal. Now, setting him off to the side, let's bring in some other figures for some comparisons. And up first, we gotta start with this. Here we have him next to MP05 Megatron. This is what we've had for the longest time. And as you can see, there is a huge, huge size difference. Now, some people have actually went and collapsed these legs, and that's kind of an alternate transformation that kind of brings them down and kind of keeps them a little bit better scale. But you look at the fusion cannon, and that is just ridiculously huge by comparison to Apollyon's fusion cannon. So that giant size thing just kind of carries over. Now, one thing that I will say is that MP05, as I've talked about before, was designed in less than 2 weeks. I've talked about this ad nauseum, and I'm sure that people are sick and tired of hearing me kind of comment on this, but when you compare the design elements that this guy has, and when you transform this, you will absolutely feel that there's a lot of similarities. These arms transform very similarly. They have a spine that comes together, and the arms swivel out. The chest collapses down. The legs have a very similar collapsing transformation. Obviously, the hands are pretty much the same. You know, they tuck in. But I mean, a lot of what they did in MP05 is carried over here. So it's almost as if X-Transbots was able to take what was originally there and basically perfect it, which to me is actually really fairly impressive. And honestly, to me, kind of speaks to how good the engineering really could have been for the actual official MP05. But since this scale is completely out of whack, let's bring in some figures that Apollyon is actually meant to scale with, that being the new, more updated scale for the Masterpiece figures from Takara. And first up here, we have Apollyon next to Masterpiece Soundwave and Fans Toys Quakewave, as well as Rumble down here. But you can see this really does look absolutely terrific. He's just a smidge taller, but it works beautifully. Now, one other little part that I really absolutely love that, honestly, they didn't need to do, but they did it, and they did it very well. The arms still pop off, but you can bring this arm up, just like so, and much like Soundwave, Megatron here has a little slot right on the top that if you want to, yes indeed, you can take it and you can put Laserbeak on there. And let me get it lined up properly, and there you have it. It tabs in wonderfully, it stays on there, and you can recreate that scene from the original animated movie where Megatron kind of takes a shot at Starscream saying that Laserbeak, unlike some of his other warriors, never fail him. I mean, that's a wonderful touch. Like I said, they didn't need to put that on there, but I really appreciate that they did. And of course, here he is next to that villainous traitor himself, Masterpiece Starscream. And again, beautiful, beautiful scale going on here. Megatron should be a little bit taller than the rest of his minions, and that carries through with a Starscream as well as the other secret molds such as Thundercracker and Skywarp. So as you can see with the Decepticons, this guy looks great. But of course, no comparison would be complete without taking a look at him side by side his arch enemy, the one and only MP10 Optimus Prime. And this is where the comparisons just need to stop, because this looks phenomenal together. Obviously, if you have all the other Autobot cars, you know, they're gonna come up to about here on both the guys, but this just is spectacular. I mean, without question, Megatron here looks amazing, but when you get him next to Optimus, it really does kind of hit that geek spot for me. I cannot get over this. This is what fans and collectors have wanted for an absolute long time, and we've been waiting. We've been very patient with Takara, and today we still have no idea if we're ever gonna get an official one, but for the time being, this just works perfectly. Now, coming back to Apollyon to take a look at his articulation, when you get things fixed on him, he's actually a really poseable figure. Coming up to his face, I mean, first off, you can see that he's got a really very cool looking face sculpt. And one thing that I'm also noticing, in addition to the dimpling that the chest does have, the crest right up here, it's going to be hard to see because of the light, but he also does have some of the dimpling on the top part right here. Now, that's a little unfortunate. I do wish it was a little bit smoother, but the face sculpt on it in general is really very nice. He's got some really wicked cool red eyes. You got some nice black highlights in there. So the head sculpt is phenomenal, and then the articulation, you can see, looks left and right, looks up and down. You get a nice range of motion there. Now, like I said, if you do fix the shoulders, you can get that going for them. And again, all I did was just add that pledge with Future Shine that I showed off, and that, well, still doesn't allow you to do that. Let me try this side, see how strong that is. That's pretty good. I mean, you can see I'm shaking it, and that's holding. I didn't put nearly as much on that because it wasn't as bad as this one, but you can see that holds on there pretty good. I'm not shaking it ridiculously, but you can see that it does hold, and now you can extend it out there, and it will hold all securely and everything for you. So you do have that range of motion there. It is on a ball joint, so now rotating this kind of makes it a little bit of a pain. I think that the overall design of the socket here is not the best. So even doing that, you can see kind of makes things a little bit problematic. You do get some flex with it as well. He does rotate at the upper part of the bicep. He does bend here at the elbow, and some people complain because when you bend it, you got this big ugly cut thing right here. It's not that bad if you actually get it properly exposed. This bottom section, you can see you got that. This section is supposed to swivel out more. It doesn't really. Some people have talked about like unscrewing it to make it a little bit looser. You can't do that, but in doing that, you get a full range of motion. That section right here will come down and kind of fill that in up as I'm throwing things around. If you just keep that, or if you get that section to come down, it kind of fills in that gap right there. So you do have that. The wrists do rotate. The fingers are all individually articulated, which is really nice. I'm just not a big fan of the way that the fingers actually are. Honestly, like I said, I don't like the thin plastic that they use to actually hold the fingers to the body. It's kind of hard to see And I keep trying to show it to you guys, just get in the right, there you can actually see it. Those are the little tiny pieces that connect the fingers to the hand, and I'm just not a big fan of that. The thumb's even worse, honestly. I really don't like that. But you do have a lot of poseability in the actual fingers. The waists can rotate side to side. These little skirt pieces can move up, and then you got the little trigger butt thing right there. So you got nice ratchet joints that if you move these pieces up, you can get a full range of motion. They move in and out. They rotate at the upper part of the thigh itself. He bends here at the knee, and then the foot does move in and out, and you got the die cast in here as well. It moves in and out. He's got a little bit of flex forward and back, and then the toe, well, I guess you could call it the toe. Very stiff. Let me try this one. Now, these actually flex, but it's hard to get it to flex a little. Well, something along those lines. Get that out of the way. There we go. You can get that to bend just like that. Very stiff on there. And then his heel also does flex. So you can get a lot of poseability with the guy. Like I said, when you assemble him properly and do the fixes, such as the shoulder bits right here. So lots of articulation that can get some really cool poses. Now, you can see this is still fairly loose on him. But one thing that's kind of neat is you do have the option. You can remove this. I don't particularly like this panel. It doesn't sit flat along the actual arm. That's a problem that I don't particularly like. Well, it's a problem and I don't particularly like it, I should say. But taking this, one thing that's really cool is you can have this look for your Apollyon, and it's again personal preference, and you can see all these little panels just keep coming undone. That's part of the aspect that I don't like about these little lower leg panels. But you can have him where he has that look for it, which is really cool. Or you can actually take this section. This will rotate forward, spin this around, and as you spin this around, spin the gun around as well. Well, or you just take the gun off and you can put it on the front. You can position this just like that, and straightening that on the arm and putting that there. Now you can have a more Megatron with his cannon front facing like so. You can't really bend him at the elbow, as you can see that doesn't leave a lot of space up there, but you can get something like that. I mean, and that's a cool look. It really is. It definitely has a very Megatron feel to it. And that's all just made possible with this little panel right here that, like I said, you just rotate, spin around just like so. So all those display options are really there because of the poseability, and they're very well articulated to pull off a lot of those poses, and just in general is really very cool looking and fun to position. Now, the bottom line is, how is this figure and should you add them to your collection? If you're a fan of Transformers, you've wanted a Masterpiece Megatron that scales with your MP10 and other figures for a long time. And if that's you, this figure is absolutely going to be perfect for you. Now, that is not to say that the figure itself is perfect. There are several problems with them. And in all honesty, I think a lot of people are being very lenient with this figure just because of the desire to have an MP Megatron that is properly scaled. Because of that, I think they're just taking some of the problems that, honestly, in an official product, I don't think we would really tolerate much, and just kind of throwing those out the window because, hey, look, it's Megatron. Yay, we finally got a new one. And honestly, I feel that's a detriment because it sends the wrong message to companies that, hey, if we're desperate enough, we'll take anything that you give us. And I really don't think that that should be the case. Now, I will give X-Trans Bots a great amount of credit because they are recognizing some of the problems that this figure has had and doing what is necessary to try and fix them. Like I said, you do get these extra shoulder pieces that, looking at them, honestly, make it look like these are a full round socket as opposed to this one, which is like a quarter of a socket. So that's probably what makes it too tight, but it also probably works a lot better. I just wish these were a little bit bigger so that they weren't nearly as tight. And then any other problems that you're having, they have said on their Facebook page that they're kind of collecting all these problems and working on addressing them with actual retailers. That's terrific, if you ask me. And way better than some companies that basically just give us a crappy figure, take our money, and run. As I said way back at the beginning of the video, X-Transbot really has taken on a lot of scrutiny recently because of the quality of some of their figures. And with Apollyon here, I really feel that they're stepping up, accepting responsibility, and doing their best to try to fix and improve their relations. I'm really happy to see that, and I'm very curious to see what the future offerings they're going to give us. But for Apollyon here, I do like him. I think he looks great. Yes, his transformation is not fun whatsoever. And that's something that's evident in other reviews that I've seen of this guy. Almost every video has shown either transforming him from his gun to his robot, which is the much simpler way of doing it because it's just basically exploding everything. You don't have to line everything up perfectly and get it to come together. Or the reviewers actually cut when they get to a difficult part and then come back with whatever transformation they're trying to do already done. So the guy is a fairly challenging transformation, and for me, just not really fun to do. But ultimately, he looks terrific, and this is how I'm gonna leave him. And this right here is probably the most important aspect of the figure. If this didn't work, nothing else would really save it. And as you could see when I was bringing out those other Masterpiece figures, he just works so well with the rest of them. Now, the first run of Apollyon figures has sold out, but Big Bad Toy Store has put up pre-orders for the next run that I think comes out in June or July. So if this is one that you want to add, all you have to do, as usual, is click on the link down in the video description. You'll go to Big Bad Toy Store where you can pick them up and add them to your collection. But beyond that, guys, that's about it. So once again, I want to thank you for tuning in. This has been Optibotomus. Don't forget that you can keep in touch with me by liking my Facebook page at facebook.com/teambotomus and by following me over on Twitter at twitter.com/optibotomus. Also, I'd encourage you to check out my website at optibotomusreviews.com, where you can see all my videos from the previous week, see what I have coming up for future release, and also get your very own Optibotomus t-shirt. And finally, I'd also really appreciate it, guys, that if you like this review, don't forget to please like and comment, and be sure to subscribe so that you never miss a future review. And until next time, I'll talk to you later.